A dangerous virus that's put some children in the hospital could soon show up here in Central Florida.
The Centers for Disease Control says more kids than usual are being seen with a severe respiratory illness.
At WESH 2's Gail Pascoe Brown has been talking to a specialist about this health scare. Gail?
Yeah, the medical director for infectious diseases at Arnold Palmer Hospital for Children says this is not a new virus. Non-polio enteroviruses were first reported around the 1960s, and there's more than 100 strains of them. Now, some of them do cause epidemic outbreaks ever so often.
School's in full force, and there's nothing better than Mrs. Brown's dress-up time at Maitland Presbyterian Preschool.
Should we put the feet in or the arms in first?
School leaders are diligent about keeping children happy and healthy by sanitizing toys on a daily basis and a hand-washing policy.
We have professional cleaning crews that come in to make sure everything is sanitized daily, and our biggest policy is to send home children that are sick.
The CDC says children are getting sick in at least a dozen other states across the country with the human enterovirus D68, which mimics the common cold.
Is it just a matter of time before it gets to Florida?
I think so. You know,
pediatric infectious disease specialist Dr. Federico Laham says about 1 in 4 patients will get fever. Other symptoms include runny nose, sneezing, wheezing, cough, right on down to body and muscle aches. What's a parent to do for a child?
If you notice any really significant difficulty with their breathing, you should take your child to the doctor right away. Parents, especially in children who have history of asthma and they start developing cough or wheezing, they should, you know, administer the medicines that they have been prescribed. And if that doesn't seem to relieve the symptoms, they should seek medical attention right away.
There's no vaccine or specific treatment for the enterovirus D68. You can get infected by having close contact with an infected person, touching objects or surfaces that have the virus and touching your eyes, nose, or mouth, and drinking water that has the virus in it.
We checked around with health officials, school districts, and they all give the same information. There are some best preventive measures that you need to take. Remember, coughing or sneezing into your elbow, make sure you have a very good hand washing practice, you know, about 20 seconds, good soap, good water, and wipe surfaces to reduce the risk from spreading the virus. Above all, stay home if you're sick. Back to you guys.
Gail, thank you. And